Hi, in this video I will show you how to measure the gain of an NPN transistor using a MonoDAC UX and DeweySoft. To determine the transistor gain, we are going to use this circuit. This is the transistor. We are going to measure the collector current and the base current, and we divide the collector current by the base current to get the gain. And we connect the power supply using the exciter pin, the power supply pin of the MonoDAC, through a 150 ohm current limiting resistor back to the current measuring input to the positive side. Internally we will select a 0.5 ohm, comes out here at the current minus pin, goes to the transistor. The transistor emitter goes to the ground pin. The collector voltage, we are going to measure it also using input 1. To create the base current, we connect a voltage to pin 8, it's a voltage output, go through the resistor into the base. We measure the input voltage and we measure the base voltage. We need these two voltages because otherwise we cannot calculate the base current, because the MonoDAC has only one current measuring input. Okay, now we can configure the MonoDAC. We do this in DeweySoft. When the MonoDAC is recognized, you will have this button. Click the button to open the inputs. Now you can configure it. So I said pin 1 would measure the collector voltage. So we set it as make it an input single buffered and with a range of 10 volts plus minus 10 volts. As you can see, this blocks input 2, so we are going to use input 3 as another voltage input, which is going to measure the base voltage. Use the same setup, this will block also input 4. Then we use input 5, again as a voltage input, to measure base input voltage. This blocks input 6. Input 7 cannot be a voltage output, or pin 7. So we use pin 8, this can be an output, and it can have a range of 4 volts. Okay, then we must configure the current input. We are going to measure current, so we make it an input. Now we don't have to configure the current, the minus input. We choose a floating shunt of 0.5 ohms. That's almost it, except for the power supply. So we set it to power supply. And this is how we configure our pins. Power supply is 0. The base voltage is also 0. We can have a maximum of 200 milliamps. So now that we have the input, we can switch to the measuring part of DeweySoft. You click for that the measure tab up here. And immediately you get a scrolling display. It's a recorder, as you can see here. Well, this is not what we want. Here you can, by the way, you can select what you want to see. I want to see voltage on pin 3, the voltage on pin 5. I want to see the current. We are going to make our own interface. To do so, you click design, or you can also click this button here. It will take you to the design screen. First, we delete everything. And now we are going to add our own graphs. So, for voltage 1, we are going to use, let's use this one. Actually, when you have a recorder like this, you can have multiple channels. Since we have 3 voltage channels, we can add them all 3. You see, automatically we get these channels here. So this one is channel 1, this one is channel 3, pin 3, and this one will be pin 5. We also want to measure the current, so we select another recorder. Why not? Make it a bit smaller. Put it at the bottom. And give it the current and not the voltage, only 1. So we have to set the voltage, the power supply also. We need a bit more space, so we can make this a little bit smaller. And we will connect the power supply to a slider, which we can get from the other, and then the control thingy. The control control is actually a multiple type of control, so we can select here the type as a vertical slider, change the size a bit, we add it here up, and this will be the, well, if it will be the input, we put it on the left side. And it's connected to pin 8, which is the base voltage, base input voltage. So then we add another one for the power supply, another slider vertically up, make it about the same size, put it in the corner, can change the color to make it more look like a power supply, red for instance. Okay, now this one is connected to A0, this one is also to pin 8, so now it's to the power supply. As you can see, it is, if you look really well, it goes up to 24, and this one only goes up to 4. With this design, we can start our measurements. For this, you click measure. And up. As you can see, we got a voltage here. This is the collector voltage, and as there is no base current flowing, the transistor is blocking, so we get the supply voltage. Let's put a voltage on the base. Oh, there we go. We can see the transistor is conducting now. We have on this one the pin 3, the base voltage, and here the base, the input voltage. And we have the base current, and the base current is now, the collector current is 60 milliamps. Okay, that's nice, but we wanted the gain. So how are we going to do that? Well, for that we need the base current, and we don't measure the base current at the moment, so we will add a mathematical channel. Do that in channel setup. And we are going to calculate it, simply. So I choose the math button from the channel setup tab. And add math. No, not add math, to add formula. Formula defaults to noise, you delete noise. And from our schematic, we remember that the base current is the voltage at pin 5 minus the voltage at pin 3 divided by, you can also use these buttons, by the value of the resistor, and I want the value in milliamps, so I use it in kilo ohms. There we go. I click OK. And now I have a math formula that I can use in my measurements. As you can see, it has appeared here, but we cannot see the result, so we have to add something for it, a display here. Let's use a digital meter. Put it here, a bit smaller, and give it, we can make it a little bit nicer by editing. Give it a can do that here. Units, milliamps. Okay. Back to measure. As you can see, it's the base current in milliamps. We have the milliamps here. We play with our control, and the base current drops and goes all the way up to 850 microamps. Okay, in a similar way, we can now calculate the gain. We simply add another formula, which we will call gain. No units. And this is a very simple one, because it's just the collector current, which is this one, divided by the calculation that I just added. And okay, back to measure, back to design, and add a value for the gain. Up, we put it here. We have a gain of 220. We are in design mode, so we cannot change anything. Back to measure mode. Ooh, negative gain. Make the voltage, the collector voltage, a bit lower. There we get a gain of 500, which is not bad. Okay, so it was quite simple to get to this, but I don't like the display really. This, the value is changing all the time, so let's change this control by something else. And maybe use something like this for the gain. Have a nicer view of the gain. Can do that. Configuring the value, we know its gain will not be below zero. And we know our transistor, which has a gain of 400 something, so we limit it to 500. We give it the gain. And it also has V1, we don't want V1, we just want the gain. We don't want this one anymore. Back to measure. And we can see how the gain changes as a function of the base current. In a similar way, you might want to change these running values because actually you don't see a lot. We can also make another modification. If we go to a very low gain, we get this wiggling value. This is because our base voltage is now very low and we are having a very large wide input range. So we can change the input range of the base voltage. As you can see, it's plus minus 10 volts. We can set it to, let's say, 2 volts, and the same for this one. And as you can see, it has become much stable. I can't find it, make it jump around anymore. Here we go. When we move the slider over 10 volts, we are no longer in the range of the pin 1, channel 1. So we don't do that. We try to stay below. Let's change the design a bit. Recorder actually does not have any real use as a display. Let's use a vertical bar for the current. So for the collector current, give it a min value of 0, the maximum value of 200. Now we can have a much better view what's happening with the currents. So in the design we can delete this graph and just use this one. With the MonoDAC and Dewey Soft you can also record your data. So in measuring mode we are measuring, as you can see. Click store. Because if you don't have any data to store, then there is no point. When done, go to analyze. Now you can replay your data and etc. And you can export your data here. All sorts of files. CSV is one of them. Lots of formats. So you choose a format. I like CSV. Here you can choose what you want in your CSV file. Give it a file name here. And then click export. Might take some while if you have a lot of data, of course. Yep, there you go. Okay, that's it. I hope this short video has given you a bit more insight in the MonoDAC and Dewey Soft and what you can do with it. Thank you for watching.